So I plan on as I'm raising my carbohydrates up into the most important show, which is Miami. I'll still be leaning out. I'll still be getting all the way glute ripped, which is what I want. That's what I always strive for. It's just the last few times I go into the show that way. You know, kind of like college. A lot of people procrastinate a little bit, and you kind of get ready for, you know, the exact study date. What 95% of the people don't do is say, well, I already knocked out my homework, I did all my flashcards, I studied weeks ahead of time, I did my extra credits, and now I'm probably going to get 110 plus extra credit. People don't do that into bodybuilding. People look at this show and they say, okay, it's going to take me this long to get all the way down to the show date. Or in this situation, I'm actually trying to be already sick, depleted looking, body fat ready, 6 weeks before the main show, 4 weeks before my regional show. So I have those 4 weeks to slightly, moderately, put them carbs back in very slowly. So we'll see how it goes. I have one of my clients right now, Eddie. He's looking so amazing. I believe his lowest carbs were at about 100 carbs. And then we had a peak week for him. We moderately brought it up a little bit. I'm a little modest with my peak week. Some people do some crazy things, and that's a whole nother video. But with Eddie, he decided that he was gonna do a show 6 weeks later, and we've gotten his carbs while having him not only stay the same leanness, if not get just a slight leaner, but we had him almost triple his carbohydrates right now. So right now he's sitting at about, I want to say 250, 260 carbs while still looking just amazing. And his next show is next weekend. So he still has the same ripness, only now his muscles are completely full while we did that. That is always the ideal scenario. It doesn't ever play out though. It's a lot harder than you say, well, everybody want to be prepared. It doesn't quite work like that. Life happens. So, you know, for everybody, if they can at least achieve the lean look that you're supposed to for a show, that's already a win for them. Now they're gonna play around a little bit with the carb load or peak week, the day of, slight deals. But in a coach's perfect world, everyone would be already to the body fat they need to 4 weeks prior to a show, so that we can moderately put them carbohydrates slowly back in to have the muscles just look completely full. Hashtag hydration.
Evidence is sick. Science.
Still with me into the abyss.
boy, Big Tank, Tankzilla, here with Eric Lee. We just finished working out shoulders, you know, we did medials and then rears. And I just want to tell you, I got my first show coming up in about 5 weeks, well, four and some change. And been prepping for it, been feeling pretty good, actually. Feeling really lean, finally. My weight dropped, as of this morning, 195, I think it was, 195.8. Feeling good, I'm about where I need to be, probably lose a little bit more body fat. But other than that, I think I'm good, and ain't doing it to win it, but I'm doing it just to say I did it. You know what I'm saying? Not too many people can say they took their bodies to that max and pushed and did it. And now we're gonna go check out this gym.
So this is gonna be where the new it's gonna be where the new Flex Level Fitness is. SBS headquarters America. So right now it's a cheerleading place, which he's one of my good friends, which he's actually moving up, so he's getting a big place, multi-million dollar place built. So we'll be taking over his spot as soon as he gets out in a few months. His place is almost done getting built. So this is when you come in, you'd be like, hey, welcome to Flex Level. Let me set you up with one of our all-star amazing trainers, our elite trainers, Evidence Base, of course. Not sure exactly what we're gonna have right here, but this is gonna be the main check-in. Might have some apparel. May have a little smoothie. I don't know.
We're just
throwing things out there right now.
Pre-workouts.
Just throwing things out there. Give them a little flex whenever people come in. It is Flex Level Fitness.
So when they come in, you actually have to hit the
flex. Yeah, you have to flex.
If you don't, you actually have to leave.
Maybe come back in and restart it. All right, so then we'll be coming through here, and this is gonna be the main gym area. All right, so we'll have some equipment right here. We'll have some more right here. This is gonna be the main open floor. This is where you're gonna have your mirrors, all the squat racks are gonna be all the way down there, the hammer strength, the dumbbells, just all types of fun. We're gonna have the option here of AC, because this is Houston, Texas. It does get scorching hot in here, okay? So we'll be utilizing the AC, but still trying to keep it a little bit more, more
garage gym-ish
without it being just too where everyone's about to pass out. So like I said, this is gonna be the main gym floor. We'll have equipment there. We'll even have equipment going down this little aisle. And then we'll have the actual SBS certified, Shredded by Science, that is, trainers in this little slot right over here. So this is where I'm gonna have mainly the trainers be at, especially with this low light, good flexing.
Perfect for posing.
Perfect for posing, but we're not gonna be posing though. We're gonna be,
we will be posing.
We will be posing, but we're gonna be training people too as well, right here. So it's a total of 3 units, 8,000 square feet. Actually in there is where we'll have our posing room, especially with that light up there. So we will have a posing room too for all our competitors. It's not just for that, it is the actual training. Just for your average person, competitor, power lifter, etc. So yeah, just gonna be those three right now. We're gonna sign a 3-year lease. Because then after this, we're going to move up to the next step, which will try to be located at an even bigger facility, at least double this size. So that's why we're only signing a 3-year lease, okay? Because we're expanding and blowing up pretty quick, building up that momentum.